Hey friends, and welcome to a new video. Today we are going to paint from my view, I think I've called the painting, and I wanted to show you a bit of my swatching process and trying out color process. Normally I wouldn't do this, but I wanted to, give this piece some little extra kick and to work even harder on this piece and with a little bit more effort than I normally would. And so I've decided on a color palette, actually took a photo with my iPad and colored it in so I can see the colors and how I want them to be layered and pre-mixed and whatnot, the colors. And yeah, I gotta say, and I took 2 days to finish this piece because I wanted to take my time, and I gotta say, for the effort I took, I thought it would be better, the outcome, but it wasn't. I mean, I like the piece, but I thought I would do better with it. I think I still rushed it in the end of the second day, but yeah. Anyway, the piece is already sold, so I hope the buyer already has it, I hope, and I hope they are happy with it, and as long as they are happy, then I am too. But I actually really like those colors. You might not know, but the color palette is right up my alley. This pink, purple, a light yellow, and some, more like, what does it look like? Salmon colored? I don't know, flesh colored? I think the tube says it's flesh color. Yeah, and what you see is some kind of distorted view out of my window. I wanted to show you my, my view of the world. Not really. I wish it was, but if it were, I had a serious drug problem. So yeah, it isn't. And I wanted to show you, kind of how I'm working and what I'm seeing. There is a mat on my window for the cats where they can sleep, and there are my plants, and there are even more plants, but I wanted to keep it simple because painting, I think I have like 20 plants on my window board, or how is it called? I don't know. And this would be kind of overkill. And the cat I used for reference was my cat Finn, but I tried to paint the cat so that it could either be Finn or Nero, maybe, but for me it looks more like Finn. But it could be any cat. And yeah, I don't know, I really like the painting. Not as much as I wish I would, but I realize sometimes the more effort you put into a piece, the more you have this idea of the piece in your head, and when it doesn't turn out like you planned it, then it doesn't give you the feeling that it should have. Does it make sense? I hope. So, when you're just sketching something out and then you're just coloring it in, and then you say, okay, it's done, perfect, or more or less perfect, and then you're done and it's okay. But if you're planning a piece for 2 days and then you're painting it for 2 days and then it doesn't turn out how you wanted it, then you're kind of disappointed. But anyways, I like the result and I like the colors. I actually kept the mixing tray thing I have there and reactivated the colors I think 3 times now because I just like them so much. And it doesn't hurt reactivating them and using them again. I mean, they are super expensive, okay? Especially the Winsor & Newton ones, which are super duper expensive, especially here in Germany, but well. I've discovered a shop in Berlin, when I was in Berlin, that has not only Winsor & Newton, but also M. Graham and Danny Smith colors. And I didn't buy as much as I wanted to, but when I get back there next year in spring, I will go back to Berlin and then I will rate this shop, I think. I also have some other colors and paints I want to try out, and you will see the videos of me trying these new art supplies in the next couple of days. So you see the first video, I think, on Wednesday, and then on Sunday, maybe, we'll see. And yeah, anyways, thank you so much for watching, and thank you for your ongoing support. And I've read your nice comments, and it's super nice, and I'm mumbling, so I will stop now and say thank you one last time, and see you next time. Bye-bye.